You can easily create a combine or merge photos from two different photos. Like, let's say you have two photos, one of a world map and another one of a group of people. You can merge and combine it easily in preview to create something like this. You can also create collages or mood boards by placing items from a variety of sources into one. You can create a mood board or collage for a project just to brainstorm ideas and so on. And it's very easy in preview. Now, I will also show you one tip that you have to be aware of when you're creating like a blank canvas for your mood board so you don't lose colors. So to merge or combine two photos, you have to have them open. So open them in preview, and let's say I have a group of people and I want to move them in onto this world map. So I would just go to my group of people, and now I would select them. Make sure you have your markup toolbar showing like right there above the photo. And I'm going to go to my crop pick selection tool and go to the lasso selection. And now I'm just going to go over the items that I want to take from one of my pictures and move it to the other. Now, the way I go about selection is basically I have my left one finger holding my trackpad, and then I'm selecting over the items that I want to crop. And obviously this is freehand selection. Maybe you will have something that's circular or rectangular. You can use the other options for cropping. And I just go over with my right hand. I'm moving my one finger over it. And this really helps versus if you're just using one hand, because many times you can lose your selection and then it gets really frustrating. Once I like this, I can go to tools and then crop, or I can just do copy. I'm actually going to crop it just so I don't lose it. And then the reason I like this, because then I can go back to it in case I, you know, have to redo my merge photo. So I can just do Control A and then Command C to copy and go to my other photo and select it and then paste it. And then, you know, you can resize it when you see the blue dots. I can resize it and I can position the person wherever. And I have a few of the other people that I did the same thing. I selected them, cut them out, and then basically I can position them. And this is like a quick way of combining and merging variety. You don't, not only two, you can have multiple photos that you're merging into one. So you see, it was very quick to just merge a photo and then you save all the objects that I pasted it here. Now, how to create a mood board or a collage in preview? You have to have a blank canvas or, you know, color canvas, but where you can put these items on. So the way to do it, a trick to do it, is basically use any program. You could use Pages or you can use Word programs. So you want to just create an empty page and you want to export it, and, you know, different programs have different options. Like if this one for Pages, you can't export to image right away, but I export it to PDF first. And once I have my PDF, if I have my PDF, then I can export it to an image. And that's how I save this blank canvas. I'm going to show you what happens if you have the blank canvas that's white or gray, because what happens, that image, it's saved in grayscale. So what happens, all the images you put on top of it, once you save it, if you don't export it to PDF before you save it, you will lose the color. So the way to go around it is, like, if I have this Pages page, I actually just do add a little bit of shade. So let's say if I select this color, then I just go to opacity, you know, I reduce the opacity to very, very low, and then I export that shade. So then now I don't have a grayscale image once I save it. So that's the way to go around it. And I'll show you what happens when you don't have it. Once I have my blank canvas, now I can place anything I like here. So let me just resize it a bit. And you can go to open any other images. I'm open a bunch of images here in preview. You can just go to any image, select all. So you just want to make sure you select the image, because otherwise it's selecting all the pictures that I have. And then Command A for select all, and go to my blank canvas, and I can paste it there. And then I can also resize it, and you still have time to resize before you save. And, you know, I'm going to go to the dog, and you just keep going. Well, everything that you like, you know, you can add to your blank canvas, go to multiple sources. Maybe you want to have some travel plans. Maybe there's something you want to purchase or what have you. Maybe there's a project ideas that you have and you want to just put it all in one place. And let's say, you know, I'm done. So I am happy with my mood board right now. So if I'm just going to export right now to PDF, because once I save, I'll show you the problem, but I'm going to just save it like this. Now, what happens if I just save it and click Command Save, and I'm going to close this. So this was done on a white canvas, and now I'm going to open that canvas. You see what happens? I lost all the colors because the mood board was in grayscale. So the way to prevent this, if you save that little bit of shade on your canvas, you won't have the problem. Or you can do what I just did just before I saved this. I saved this as PDF, and the PDF saved the colors, and then I just went to the PDF and exported it to an image. If I save bluish shade, if I'm going to paste a couple of items here, like car and maybe something that you can see the color, maybe the world map there. So then if I save this, you can see that the color is still there. So that's the work around to make sure you don't lose the colors. So thanks so much for watching.